All right, so welcome everybody to an all dance class. Did you know that? She's like, uh-oh. So we are going to have a new dance today, as always, but there is actually a theme to this whole class. There's a theme to it. And I don't want any show of hands. I think everybody would raise their hands, but no show of hands because I want you to think about right now, do you have something heavy on your mind? Mm-hmm. I do. I have two things that are really, really heavy on my mind. I mean, so heavy that sometimes I just want to cry right now, okay? That's how my life is at this moment. And we know that, right? Life can change like that. Some days are good, some weeks are good, some months, whatever. Right now, I've got it coming in two directions. And sometimes it's our own physical health and our own stuff, right? But isn't it sometimes other people's stuff? Yeah. It's other people's stuff. And unfortunately, right now, I have two other people's stuffs that are heavy on me. You know, I feel like I'm okay, right? But right now, it's heavy. So this theme of this class is like, everything's gonna be all right, right? Everything is gonna be all right. No matter what is going on, and you're in the forest, right? And you don't see the trees, but we're gonna say this to ourselves, our beings, all of our fellow yogis, that everything's gonna be all right, right? So we're gonna close our eyes, and we're just gonna get into that nice quiet spot. So. And I'm going to invite you this time to welcome the thoughts, right? Especially the deep worries that we have, right? Because I want you to feel it, you know, if you start crying, you know, get a Kleenex. But if you feel it, that's okay. Those emotions are okay. Sometimes we need to feel it and let them bubble in and up. But at the end of class, we're also going to check in and just see. We're going to see if we've lightened our load a little bit, okay? That is my hope for myself, and that is my hope for you. So just take some mindful breaths. Just mindful, just notice what you're moving, what you're breathing in, what you're letting go of. And I've always heard this, I believe this to be true, that we come into this world in a way alone in our spirits, right? We go through that birth canal process alone. And we also leave this earth alone as well. But while we're on this earth, there have been people placed in our lives for a purpose. And that's why when we carry the loads of other people, we are meant to. We are meant to help share that load with them. So if there's anybody right now that you're helping to share a load with, just reach out to them. Let them know that you're there helping. If not physically, maybe spiritually. And then gently take a nod up and down, saying the yes, yes, yes is in life. And then when your chin is down, we're gonna go side to side. So just that nice moving, stretching feeling in your neck. We carry the weight of the world sometimes, and we feel it in our neck and shoulders. So this nice little motion is just like stretching that. Let's get rid of some of that feeling of weightedness. And then the next time the right ears to the right shoulder, the left arm is all the way out. We're going to spread the fingers really wide, open and close the fingers. Spread and reach. Take a couple of deep breaths and just stretch. Let's get something moving on the inside of us as well, the outside. Good. And then when you come back down, your chin and your hand are back to the center. We'll go to the other side, left ear, left shoulder. Right hand reaches out. And again, an open and close, stretch the webbing. Go ahead and come all the way back down. Give yourself a nice little neck rub. So this is that little self-love moment, right? So wherever it feels good, so it could be all along your neck, your cervical spine, or you can come into the shoulders and the beefy trapezius muscle that probably feels a little tight maybe. This is where we carry tension too. So just kind of like, you know, smoosh in there, pinch, poke. And then with your fingertips to your shoulders, we're gonna just open our hearts. And then we're gonna take it together, and then we're gonna open our hearts. Good, and take it together, and one more time, open our hearts. And then a big stretch, thumbs are up, and we're gonna give everybody in the room a big hug right now. So big hug, group hug, group hug. Good, and then open up again. And a group hug again. And one more time, a big hug, big stretch. Good, and that group hug. Good, and then pull that energy in and be strong right here, be strong. Hold that, good. And then release, take one leg and the other, and then shake them and move them. Okay, so the verse song, which will be the theme pretty much of the class, is everything here is all right, okay? So we've done this song before, and there'll be other songs building on that same concept. This one's a slow one, which is nice, because it's a nice warm-up. We're gonna take the legs out a little straddled, okay? So the code word for anything that's in the straddled position is that we're also working your core, your back muscles, and your inner thigh muscles. So all of those get moved and worked when we're in the stance. We're gonna take the hands, and we're gonna sway like this, right? And that's it. After that, you're good. You're good, yeah. That's how easy this dance is. You're gonna follow along with me and you'll notice it's gonna be really easy. And this is what I want you to think about throughout the whole class. If you don't know the steps, if you forget the steps, find the rhythm, right? The rhythm, the rhythm. Everything is a 1-2 beat, a 2-4 beat, a 4-6 beat, right? All that. So yeah, look at Larry's already there with the rhythm, right? So everything is about finding the rhythm, right?
The smell of open the heart. Flowers and your hand in mine, sun slipping slowly over the mountain,
and then sway,
and me looking into your eyes.
Big sun circle.
I want this
sway.
Feeling always.
Back down,
quiet,
back to the heart,
colors
the heart.
Of every hue, wandering
good. Big sun circle
into
sway.
Nighttime in paradise.
Back to your heart, crisscross the heart. Now only the right arm is going to go out.
Gold,
there's four of these.
Shades are everywhere. There's no world filled with heavenly light. Everything here is all right.
Good. Good, you guys. Now we're just going to sway again. Good. Crisscross the heart.
Midsummer
evening. Sun circle.
Moments of beauty have brought us together, and nothing can take
good. Back
that
to your heart, crisscross.
Apart.
Just the right arm's gonna go out.
Gold shades everywhere. No time, no care in this world. Filled with heavenly light, everything here is all right.
Now big sun circle.
In this world filled with heavenly
grab
light,
grab the heavenly light and bring it back to your heart.
Everything here is all right.
That's soothing for the soul, that little message, right? So everything here is all right. And we have to continually remind ourselves of that, right? Because we forget sometimes. And we're going to do a song that I think is all about magic. And I think as us as humans, sometimes we think that we have to solve every single problem, right? Sometimes when we have faith, it's good, right? And faith really gets us through a lot of things, and also a little bit of magic, a little sprinkle of magic. So we're going to do Catch a Falling Star and Put It in Our Pocket. So we've been doing this song for a while, so I think we have a lot of little sparkly stars in our pockets. So if you need to pull those out in the next couple of weeks or days, I know I do. So that's what this song is all about, right? We're just catching the star, putting it in our pocket, and we're saving it for a rainy day. So we're gonna bring the arm up as we catch the star. We're gonna take it over across the chest and put it in the pocket and never let it fade away. And then the other side is catch a falling star, put it in your pocket, save it for a rainy day. And this is the rain. Good. And then when love comes and taps you on the shoulder, one starless night. Yeah, so that's that one. And then the next time we do it, we're going to reach for the star, and this time we put it in the hip pocket. Okay, good. And then we do the other one, and we put it in the hip pocket. Never let it fade away. And then we'll save it for a rainy day. And that's pretty much it. Okay? And who sings this song? Don't tell me. Anybody else? Perry Como. All right. Very good. All right.
Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away.
Good. Other side.
Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a rainy day. For love may come and tap you on the shoulder some starless night. Just in case you feel you want to hold her, you'll have a pocket full of starlight. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a rainy day.
Save it for a rainy day.
For love may come and tap you on the shoulder.
Open and close.
Some starless night.
Not so sweet.
And just in case you feel you want to hold her, you'll have a pocket full of starlight.
Pocket full of starlight.
Here's the magic. Mm-hmm.
Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a rainy day. For when your troubles start multiplying, and they just might, it's easy to forget them without trying. With just a pocket full of starlight, catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a rainy day.
Save it for a rainy day.
Save it for a rainy day.
Now wiggle. Do, do. Good. Wiggle. Why not? Do, 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 do. All right. Yay. That's a fun one. I forgot to tell you the filler on that song was this. Right, that little motion. So every song has that. If you don't know what you're doing, you can just do one of these little motions, okay? So how are we doing? Okay? All right, bring one foot up, point and flex it, twirl it around. Good, and then twirl it around. Good, the other one. Good, a little bit, and then twirl it. So I do have one of my relatives right now in a rehab center. So I've been visiting a lot, and she's been doing a lot of PT work. And this is the one thing that they told her to do. I thought it was so cute and so clever. They said, every time you get up from the chair, from your bed, anytime that you're in a position that you have to stand up, you put on the gas pedal, which is this. Don't we do this a lot? We talk about this a lot, right? This motion, because the calf is considered the second heart, and it pumps the blood in your extremities, and it helps you from being dizzy when you stand up, right? So you can get lightheaded. So she's been doing that recently. She said it really, really helps. So those little tricks we learn, we don't have to go to a rehab center to learn that, right? We know how good that is. So take your legs out wide, and we're just going to go side to side a little bit, little windshield wiper. All right. So they always say that if you focus on what you're grateful for, sometimes your problems be a little bit more diminished, right? And sometimes we're wrapped up in the problems and we don't think about the good stuff, right? So that's why this song, I really love this song so much. It's called I Live on the Corner of Joy. Joy, joy, joy. That's joy, right? And gratitude, right? Those two beautiful virtues. right? If we have joy, which is just not happiness, it's just joy of just feeling like, wow, I can breathe, yay, I'm sitting in a chair, yay, you know? Whatever that is, that's joy. It just is a moment in time. And then gratitude. So everybody with their eyes closed and their hands to their heart, I want you to close your eyes and I want you to think of three things that you're grateful for. And don't think a lot, just come the first things that come to your mind. Good. And then open your eyes, okay? So when we do that, we kind of shift a little bit, right? Because we can think of the good stuff. Anybody have a pet in the top three? Anybody's pet made the top three? No, my pet made the top three. I have a very special cat. Okay, so this is how it goes. The whole theme of the song is very playful, so we're going to skip, okay? So skip is alternating feet and hands, and it's a toe tap, Penny. Yeah, good. Okay, that's the skip. And then if you can do this, we're really super happy, right? Good, we're skipping, and that's usually about 8 rounds, I think. And then we're putting a happy on, so this is always a happy, because we're singing our favorite song, right? And then we skip a little bit more, and the whole chorus is this: I live on the corner of joy and gratitude, right? That's pretty much it, you guys. We repeat that 3 times, and then there's a little bit of filler in between, so you'll get it. Ready to skip.
Living at the corner of joy and gratitude.
Get the happy on.
I got my happy on.
Sing.
Living my favorite song.
Good, skip again.
Flowers are blooming and skies are always blue.
And we live.
Living at the corner of joy and gratitude.
Lift up the left leg with your arms. Here we go. Up and down.
My own party,
and then a big hip circle there.
Own celebration.
Good. Other side. Up.
Life is the
good
reason each day.
And then a big circle.
Occasion.
We're going to go out wide. So one leg.
Celebrate.
Other leg. Arms. Go up. We're celebrating we're alive. Yeah. How happy are you?
Corner of joy and gratitude.
Keep a happy on.
I got my happy on.
Sing.
Singing my favorite song.
And skip again.
Flowers are blooming and skies are always blue.
And where do we live?
Living at the corner of joy and gratitude.
So the left leg's gonna go in and out. Here we go. Up and out.
Life is for living.
And a circle.
I'm gonna live it.
Good, other side. Up.
Love is for giving and I'm gonna give it.
Good, that wide goddess.
To celebrate being alive.
I'll stay up because we're gonna sway.
What a gift to be happy, joyous,
oh,
and
the
free.
Here we go.
Living at the corner of joy. I got my happy on.
And sing.
Living my favorite song.
Last time.
Flowers are blooming and skies are always blue.
And we live.
Living at the corner of joy and gratitude.
Good, two more like that.
Living at the corner of joy and gratitude.
Get ready to kick up a leg. Ready? Bum, bum.
Yay! I love you. I love you. Thank you.
So great.
Thank you.
Thank you. You brought us so much joy today. So
oh,
thank you.
And you, I wanted thank you to. You brought me joy.
Thank you.
Thank you. So yes, glad. Yes, yes.
We so appreciate you and your music and your talent.
I love doing it.
I know
it's,
you do.
Know.
So I wanted you to share just a little bit of what motivated you to write that song. Where did that come from?
Well, obviously from a TV ad.
Okay, a commercial.
A commercial.
That's not
you know, at the corner of Happy and Healthy.
Oh, okay. Walgreens.
Was it Walgreens? I couldn't remember which drugstore. And I went, well, you go to Happy and Healthy to get, you know, prescription drugs. But I went, I want more than just medical health. And it's spiritual, you know, and we have a choice to be happy. And when we're in gratitude, we're gonna be in joy. It's that gives me physical health.
So what I've done, and she allowed me to do this, is I put the dance on YouTube, and then I have a link to download it. And people can contribute $1, $5, or $10, and that money goes to her. So it's such a cool thing. So we're getting her work out there. And what is the most common amount you think that people choose?
Five.
One.
Oh, that's cheap.
I know. So yeah. I'm like, doggone it. So I just told her, I said, that's what you're getting, so that's all good. But we continue to have that exposure for her, so that was really special. Okay, so take your legs out and move them just anyway. Take your hands and move them. Just kind of fiddling right now to get the heart rate back down. Speaking of fiddling, let's do twiddling. Twiddling, thumbs, twiddle the other way. Good. Interlace, good. Push it out and bring it back to your heart. Push it out, back to your heart, and one more. Push it out, and then it's gonna go up. And then a big circle around. Oh, I think we need to do that one more time. Up, push it out, bring it up, and a big circle around. Good, and then wiggle a little bit. So as I promised, I'm gonna be building in more standing classes. So you decide if you wanna do it standing, everything else is you can follow along with the arms, right? And the reason this is because when we stand and we dance, we're working our balance even more so. We understand that, right? Because we're shifting our weight, we're doing some movements while we're trying to balance. I always encourage you to hold onto the chair. All the dances I do on purpose so that we can hold onto the chair. So are we ready to get up? All right, come on up. All right, so we're gonna just do a little stretch here before we dance. So this is going to be the pony, which actually is a dance, right? So we're gonna just go like this, which is alternating. Heels down, and then on your tippy toes, good. It's called prancing these days, but I always call it the pony. Good. All right, and then add a little hip attitude in there. Moving side to side, good. Good. And then let's take one arm up with the palm facing in, so a nice big stretch, good. And then come down, and the other arm is up. Good, and come down, and let's do both arms up. Oh, your spine loves this. Look how your posture is so tall and straight. Good, and then bring your hands back. Let's come into downward facing dog. So we're just gonna give some little bit of stretch and some prana into our spine. So when you walk back, make sure you bend your knees a little bit. Don't ever lock your knees on this pose. And then you're gonna just gently pull and stretch. And I want you to do that on your exhale. So inhale, you make it everything wide, and then exhale, you're just pulling and stretching. We're just stretching into the fascia, into the muscles, even in between those vertebrae. That's where arthritis sets in our spine, those little gaps of space, those little spurs come in there. So we're just moving things around. If you want to, do that little bit of pony or the prancing, right? Get that to move a little bit. Remember, this pumps your blood back up to your heart, so it keeps your feet healthy. And then look all the way at your thumbs and come all the way back up. Good. And then everybody's got the chair in front of you. Okay, so this song has very familiar, it's a new song, but it has very familiar movements to it, okay? So this is what we're gonna do first. This is the only, I think, new thing that we're gonna do. We're gonna take, and I always mirror you on this, okay? So we're gonna take your left heel out and just your heel is down, and then it comes in, and then your right heel, good, comes in. Can anybody guess, just starting like this, what kind of song genre it is? No, can't guess yet, okay, we'll see, what? Yeah, country. It's a country song. It's country. Okay? And then the next round, we do the push, right? So we always, like, increment it, right? Now, those of you who feel like this is so easy breezy, then do both, right? You're always having that option. Good. All right, so that's the first round. Then the second round is we do the curtsy. So So you guys, this one, the only thing that's different with this one is we're going to start in the back. So watch, it goes out and crisscross to the back, out, crisscross forward, out, curtsy. Okay, let's try the other side. So it goes out, tap in the back, out, tap in the front, out, the full curtsy. Now remember, you can hold on with the curtsy. You don't have to lift up the skirt part, right? So that is that one. And then the last one, okay, so there's three verses, as you can imagine, is the pendulum. Now this one looks like this. The leg is out and the arm is like this. So it's the opposite. Remember we do that little side saddle thing? So remember, it's the opposite. So if the foot is back, the arm is up. The foot is forward, the arm is down. Yeah. I can see everybody's brain really working on this one. Yeah, that one, and I threw that one in last, okay? So here we go, we're gonna try it. Okay, so I always think about the foot goes back and the arm goes up. Yeah, so even if you wanna stay there the whole time, you'll go, that guy got it, right? And then otherwise, you'll see the beat, okay? Now, because the theme of our class is, you know, everything's going to be all right, guess what this song is called? Everything's going to be all right. I mean, that's another song. It's that way, okay? So this is what the motions are, okay? Everybody to the heart. Everything's going to be all right, all right, all right. Nobody's gotta worry about nothing. Don't go hit that panic button. It ain't bad as you think. Something like that, okay? You'll get it, right? So that's the motion. That happens three times, okay? So everything's gonna be all right, all right. Good, and maybe catch an eye of a person when you're doing that, right? Nobody's gotta worry about nothing. Don't go hitting that panic button. It isn't, oh, I always forget this part. It isn't bad as you think, okay? That's contra Western verses, okay? And that's pretty much it. You guys ready? Let's give it a go, okay? What do we start with? Heel out four times, and then the push and the push. And by the third verse, you got it. There's got such a rhythm in this one.
She rattled the ass in my plastic cup. I said, yes, ma'am, fill her up. Tell me something good that I don't know.
Now a hand and a foot.
Cause this world's been kicking my behind. Life ain't been a friend of mine. Lately I've been feeling kinda low.
Now watch, the left arm's gonna go
and
like this.
She looked back over her shoulder.
And the other side.
Pointed at the sign hanging up on the wall.
Good, and
say, everything's gonna be alright. Everything's gonna be alright. And nobody's gotta worry about nothing. Don't go hitting that panic button. It ain't worth spilling your drink. Everything's gonna be alright, alright, alright.
Hold on.
So I nodded my head and said
back.
That's for sure. Dropped a few butts in the mason jar. Felt those good old neon vibes on me.
Good. Alright, other side.
And whatever monkey that was on my back, he jumped off just like that, right into the deep blue sea.
Good, now that arc.
And I look back over her shoulder, thinking about the sun hanging up on the wall. Let's say everything's gonna be alright. Everything's gonna be alright. Nobody's gotta worry about nothing. Don't go hitting that panic button. It ain't near as bad as you think. Everything's gonna be alright, alright, alright.
Good, now push away that bad energy.
There ain't no doubt it's gonna work out. Come on and sing it with me. Everything's gonna be alright. Everything's gonna be alright. Nobody's gotta worry about nothing. Don't go hitting that panic button. It ain't near as bad as you think. Everything's gonna be
so good, sentimental. Come on down. And I know you guys know this. There's always signs on the wall. That's why I thought that song was so cute. Like, look at the sign on the wall. It always says that everything's going to be all right, and we just walk by it, right? So next time you see that sign, really take that to heart, right? That's what it's trying to tell us, to take those things to heart. So take a moment, close your eyes, find your breath. And then open your eyes. We're going to do a little sun circle lotus mudra, okay? So we're going to take it like this, all the way up, and then all the way down. And then once you get down, I want you to bring the back of your hands together in front of you, pull them in, flip it, make a little bud, and then reach that bud all the way up and open. And then bring it all the way back to your heart. Good. And again, inhale up. And then push all the way down, back of your hands touch in front of you. Pull in, flip it, make the bud, and then as you rise up, that bud opens up, comes back together, and then back. Good, now three middle fingers move, the other two stay connected. Open, close, open, close, good. The bud opens and closes, very good. Very good, and then shake it. So with worry, stress, and anxiety, all of those things are very internal to our bodies. Nobody can really see what we do on the inside. So the worry and the anxiety is all in the mind, right? It's replaying thoughts over and over again. Someone just told me this week that 80% of our normal everyday thoughts are thoughts we've already done over and over again. I believe that, right? 80%. So if you can start maybe shifting in some new thoughts in there, right? And then the stress of worry and anxiety can manifest in our physical structures. So gently flutter your eyes open if they're closed. And the most common place for our stress is here, in the gut, in the gut, in the digestive area. When things are tight and bound and stressful and we hold, because we're like holding on for dear life to get through something, right? So that is a very important part of our beings that we need to allow ourselves to let go of, right? So we're going to take it nice and wide, and we're going to do a couple of cat-cows just to open up the front of our bodies. So you're going to take your palms to your hip bones, and you're going to arch and get the belly to open and expand. And then when you take your hands over your kneecaps, I want you to pull your belly button in and then squeeze. Think about like wringing out like a sponge. So we're going to inhale. We're going to bring movement and prana and blood flow into that space. And then exhale. We're going to pull it and squeeze it, squeeze it, squeeze that belly button in. Do two more times. Inhale. We're going to arch it. And exhale. We're going to round it. And last one, inhale, arch, and exhale, round. Good, and then coming all the way back up, and then walk it back together. Yeah, bless you, bless you. So I know that we all know this, and I'm just going to reinforce it, especially as we start to get older in life. We realize that time is shorter than it was before, right? We know that. And so I have a lot of people always saying, go and do the things you love to do. Go and do it. Go that trip. Go see that friend. Go and do all those kind of things. And that is why I like this song. We have two more, but this song I think is near and dear to everybody's heart. It's The River by Garth Brooks. And it's all about that, is that we're going to live every single life. Our vessel is sailing down the river, and we don't know when the last day is going to be. We have no idea. So doing all the things you want to do, all the things you love to do, all the things you hope that you would maybe do sometime in your life, do it now, because we're not guaranteed anything after that. So this movement is a lot of swaying. So remember, anytime we sway, it's a nice wide straddle so that we are building our core strength as we sway. Okay, so there'll be a lot of those things, right? And then it's this movement. We're going to reach across with our left hand. We're going to grab in the middle, and we're going to turn around, and we're going to drop. So that goes twice. And I think about like reaching, grabbing, whatever that trouble is, right? And then turning and toss it behind us. We don't want it anymore. At least a moment or two, we don't want it. Good. And then the left arm is in cactus. We crisscross. It's in cactus, and we crisscross. And then the other side, of course, both times. And then the last thing would be V for victory. So it's one arm and another arm. Clap at the top, bring it back to the heart, and then we smoothly glide around. Good. All right. So that's it. We do that three times. Oh, yeah. Thank you so much. There's Heike in the front row. You can't see her. She's really helping right now. We swipe the table three times. It looks like this. Swipe.
This is my favorite move.
Oh, it is. No wonder. Okay. This one is super good. Well, for the back. But let's think of the analogy of just moving things off of our plates, right? Gosh, we just poured a lot of things on our plates, right? So they just push it off. Good. And that goes into the V for victory. So why don't we do that one more time so we really get the whole thing going on there? All right. All right. Here we go. Garth Brooks. This one is dedicated to Miss Joyful. Her chair is there waiting her. Okay, waiting her return. Okay, so here we go. Nice and tall and straight. Good. Look at that good posture everybody has. And remember, you're finding the rhythm. In every song, you're just finding it. Your body will love it when you find it. Good. Left arm is going to reach across.
You know a dream is like a river.
Now throw behind you.
Ever changing as it flows.
Good, other side.
And the dreamer's just a vessel that must follow where it goes.
Left arm and
trying
cactus.
To learn from
Chris
what's
cross.
Behind you. And never knowing what's in store.
Other side.
Makes each day a constant battle just to stay between the shores.
Good. Four swipes of the table. Clear it off.
And I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Like a bird upon the wind, these waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry.
Good, we're gonna repeat the whole thing. Left arm's gonna reach.
Too many times we stand aside and let the water slip away. What we put off till tomorrow has now become today.
Army
so don't
cactus.
You sit
Chris
upon
Fox.
The shoreline and say you're satisfied.
Other side.
Choose to chance the rapids and dare to dance the tide.
Good. Clean that table four times.
Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Like a bird upon the wind, these waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry.
Good, left arm and cactus.
And there's bound to be rough waters, and I know I'll take some falls.
Other side.
But with a good Lord as my captain, I can make it through them all.
Wipe the table.
Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Like a bird upon the wind, these waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination
If I never try, so I will sail my best.
Good.
Till the river runs dry.
Okay, let's see seaweed and the
yes,
water.
I will sail my best.
Swirl.
Till the river
open
runs dry.
Open up those
dry.
Armpits. Use your belly muscles. Oh, yeah.
Till the river runs dry.
And then we're going to sway at the top. Remember, we're just like seaweed, so you don't have to be straight and aligned here, right? You're just being fluid. And then start to bring your hands into prayer at the top, and then slowly sway back down. And then bring your hands to your heart center. Close your eyes, soften your shoulders, your face. Take a little bow down and just take a moment. Walk your feet back together. All right, beautiful, beautiful sentiment, everyone. We're gonna end it with the song, Stay Strong, Keep Your Faith Alive. Thought this was a grand finale for the theme, right? It's all about staying strong in our spirits and in our bodies, in our attitudes. This was the very first chair yoga dance I ever did. I was introduced to chair yoga dance by Olga Danilevich from Toronto. Were you there in that class? You were, right? Look at how many dances we've done since that one, right? Wow. She was the one that introduced me to the concept of doing these beautiful movements to inspirational songs. So this one is Stay Strong, Keep Your Faith Alive.
First of all, does everybody know how I met her?
No.
So Justin and I travel and do a couple of workshops a year. And last year we went to North Carolina and she was a teacher at the workshop. And in some break, she said, you know what, I do chair yoga too for seniors, of course, we knew that. And she said, but I do chair yoga dance for seniors. And we like, what is that? We had no idea what that was. She says, do you think maybe I could do a dance for you? And so we said, sure. So at the end of the workshop, she got up here and she did this most awesome dance. She had us all laughing and giggling, and Justine will attest, it was really fun.
It was awesome.
And we just thought that it was something to offer to our community.
And this song is a song of David Newman, like Durga Das, a beautiful, beautiful musician who writes a lot of songs that really spread love around people. And this song is called Stay Strong. Yeah, so let us dance together. And I won't teach you because it's, like you will see, it's lots of repetitive movements. And feel free to improvise, and maybe a little bit louder, maybe.
Side by side.
guys, you made it. That was 60 minutes of dancing almost. How do you feel? Ready for a nap? Whew. All right, so come on down. You know what the drill is. If you want to come down on the floor, feet up, really good for your circulation. Otherwise, if you're in the chair, you do get a neck rub. So both things are good for you. And maybe this is a good time to, as you settle in, to notice your thoughts, right? Remember at the beginning and we kind of noticed what we were thinking? Notice now in the 60 minutes that have passed where your mind has traveled in those 60 minutes. If we've been able to lighten the mental load in our spirits, that's always helpful. What we call peace of mind, when we can have the mind a little clearer instead of dwelling on those 80%. And then even notice now your jaw, if your jaw feels tight, separate your teeth. Notice if your shoulders feel like they've lifted, maybe drop them a little bit, and then of course, notice the abdomen area. Just notice if there was any tightening there and see if you could just take a couple of deep breaths into the belly. Soften and soften. And then that beautiful mantra that we've heard a couple times in class today, that everything's going to be all right. Right? No matter what's going on. For all of us warriors in the room, I want you to remember this. This is really important, that worry is not a badge of honor, right? It's not like the more that we worry and the more weight that we carry, we're a better person. Have faith, let go, do what you can, but don't let it just infuse your being. From our beautiful Shavasana time, like a new person, right? So just take a nice deep breath in, maybe a long reach, a stretch, a wiggle, a point and a flex, whatever feels good, and just take your time as you transition. So as you roll to the right, you know you're going to pause there for at least a breath or two, and then start to make your way back to a comfortable position. You could stay on the floor or make your way back to the chair. And then bring your hands to your heart in that prayer position. But we're going to create that little lotus flower again. So the thumbs and the pinkies stay touched and the three middle fingers open. And the thumbs are touching right into the center of your heart. Bow your head for a moment. And now this lotus flower has turned into this beautiful magical chalice coming right into your heart. So just now ask for whatever your heart desires at this moment. It could be for yourself, someone else, and you could even ask a couple of things, why not? Whatever your heart desires, just ask for that. And bringing your fingertips back together, take a moment, thank yourself for caring for your mind, body, and spirit by being here today. Thank you for carrying the load of compassion and love in this world for ourselves and others. Wish you all a beautiful weekend and a namaste. Namaste. And a little greeting to all of you. Namaste. Namaste. Namaste to you all. Namaste. Great. All right, you guys, you're all good. You're all good to go. I will see you in a week. So remember, this next week I won't be here. I will be celebrating my dad's 88th birthday in North Carolina. So I'll be gone Monday and Friday, but I will be back the following Monday. All right? All right? And once a month we do this dance class. So that means the first Monday in August. First Monday in August. All right?
Sounds good.
Good.